So YouTube, it's your girl Tasha. Today is Thursday, November 4th, and we're kicking off the B-Day vlog. My birthday is Friday, November 5th. So today, we're going to get my hair cut. And going to the Beauty Supply Store so I can figure out what I'm going to do with this head. I may or may not be getting my feet done. I really don't need my feet done. So it'll be more so like, I'm just doing it just to do it at this point. But I think I can go. Let me check these feet. I mean, my gel pedicure, so good. I just gotta check the bottoms. Okay, I'm good. They still silky smooth. So probably like another, I can go in like another 2 weeks. So I may or may not get the pedicure today. It depends on how I feel because my barber takes an hour to cut my hair. And gel. So I'm gonna get a design. I'm gonna get my design put back in. I'm gonna go a little lower. I'm gonna get more hair taken off. I'm thinking about dyeing my hair. I don't know. Like my natural hair color is jet black, and I love my hair jet black. But for some reason, I want to color my hair. But I know ultimately, I'm gonna cut it out and take the color out of my hair. And I definitely have to bleach my hair to do color. So I don't know. For some reason, I want to dye my hair and don't tell my boyfriend and just like surprise him. But I know like after like 3 or 4 days, I'm like, why did I do this in my hair? Why did I do this in my hair? So I don't know. But either way, we want to be supposed to. I need some stuff to do my hair, regardless of what I do. And then we're either going to do my hair tonight or early tomorrow. We may do it early tomorrow so I can just be fresh. So we'll do that. I need to clean my makeup brushes. Friday is going to be packed. Friday, I had to run in Target, get some things for the house. Just to give you guys like an itinerary, what we got going on. So Friday, we got to go to Target, get some things for the house. I'm going to breeze on, boppity-boppity on through, see what I can find. Because according to the poll, you guys want a Target clothing haul. I got some things in my cart online, but I want to see what I can see in the store. Then I gotta come home, figure out what I'm wearing, which we probably will tackle that tonight. You guys will probably get a sneak peek of some thoughts in my head, but I'm not gonna show you guys the thing until I figure out what I'm gonna do, so you guys can be like, ew. So gotta do that. Then we gotta do my press-ons, but that'll be tomorrow. And do my makeup, it'll get ready with me. Give you guys an update on my homeowner issues. I don't even want to talk about it right now because, sweetie. But anyway, if you're new, hey, well, my name is Tasha. I focus on fashion, beauty, and lifestyle, mainly fashion. Occasionally, I may do some vlogs. I haven't vlogged in a while. And something else I want to tell you guys. I can't even remember, but see y'all at the barbershop. So yes, I'm mad that I didn't have any cash on me because this Beauty Supply Store, they give you like points every time you purchase and I go there regularly. So I would have got $10 off my purchase and I would have had to pay $2.69, but I didn't have any cash and they wanted to be at minimum like $5. So I got $10 for the next time. So we're gonna go to the barbershop. And I bet you a mirror is not ready. Oh, that's my barber. It's kind of hot. Like being a dinner shirt. The hardest to end is for like 20 minutes. 25 something to do. I feel it in my feet right now, but that's how long it's been. Okay, you guys, so I'm back home and here is my haircut. And then, of course, I got all this pinned down. So, I'm going to eat. I got a catfish sub from America's Best Wings. So, I'm about to go ahead and eat and watch Chicago PD. And I'll probably do my hair tomorrow because I don't want to put that perm on this right now. It is too fresh from the razor. So we just do my hair sometime tomorrow. So let's go ahead and unwind and figure out what we're gonna watch on TV. So this is my grilled catfish sub with french fries. It has everything on it. Tomatoes, provolone mayo, grilled onions, bell peppers, provolone mayo, lettuce, tomato, and some other stuff. I probably won't even eat all of this. And my little Pepsi. So you guys, I am just gonna finish watching Law and Order and Organized Crimes. I'm gonna get up early and clean my brushes. And they should be dry by 2 o'clock, 2:30. That's when I plan on doing my makeup. I like 2 o'clock. Cause I'm tired now. But I did put my outfit together. It's so sick. Like, it's so sick. All I can tell you guys, if you are a fashion girl, you're gonna die. You're gonna die, okay? But I will link the items in the description box. And all I'm gonna tell you guys is that I'm doing something with that green blazer that I got from H&M. Fire. And I have no clue how I'm gonna style my hair. I guess I need to sit here and think about that too. Now that I got my outfit together. But I'll see you guys tomorrow. Good morning, y'all. So today is the day. It is my birthday, Friday, November 5th. She's 38. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and get ready to do my hair. So I got the olive oil, perm, and extra strength. Okay. So even though I have like a silkier texture hair, as far as like not silky as in like my hair has slipped to it. But my hair is very thick and it is coarse as well. So I need the extra strength to get the waves out of my hair because my hair will still be curly with the relaxer. right, y'all. So I have, ooh, you see that? I think I must have had a nick or something from the razor blade or the clippers. Well, hopefully when my hair dries and I put some oil and stuff in it, I can camouflage that. Because that's definitely going to bother me. Alright, so I have washed out the relaxer. I have deep conditioned my hair. My hair is long enough for me to roll it, but I'm just not in the mood to be rolling no hair. So I think I'm gonna do my finger waves. Since a couple of you guys always message me about how I do my finger waves. And that's the easiest thing. So, but I got too much to do to be playing around with rollers. So I'm using my Nairobi. This is, if you got a short haircut, this is your saving grace. Now, I don't need that much on this side, but Nairobi, it just gives your hair like the sheen, and it smooths out really good. And if you don't have a perm, like, it's still, like, if you're in between relaxers, it still will make your hair lay down really, really good. Nairobi is expensive. It depends on, like, the resupply store. The most I've paid for is maybe like 13, 14 bucks, but sometimes I just buy like the big bottle from Amazon for like, used to be like $23, $24, but with this inflation, I think it's closer to 30 now, but it's worth it because I can just constantly fill up my bottle. Okay. So that's all the foam that we're going to use. And then just go ahead and smooth everything out. My hair's going to dry really fast. So I smoothed all my sides first. Then smooth this. Now this is gonna be different because I don't have like the extra hair on the side. So this is gonna lay a lot smoother. So you can either pull this way first. So it's like going in a C motion. And I'm pulling down and it's coming around. The best comb to use is a rat tail comb or all-purpose comb for this. It just depends on what you're more comfortable with in your hand. Okay, so now I got the C motion that's coming down. And then right here where the ridge is where you want to start catching it to come back up, and you're still moving in a C motion. And then I'm gonna come back down and catch where the ridges are right there, and come back down and take off any excess foam that you don't need. and do the C's. And you're just gonna repeat that. And then come back and catch it. This is why I love doing finger waves, because it's, for me, it's so easy and I don't have to do nothing else. Because once I do the rollers, I gotta pluck and style, and this is just like done as soon as it's dry. And I think I got a little bit of hair back here. It's not caught up in that. That I can just feel it. And like even my little shave side, I have enough hair where I can still wave that to blend it in. I could wave this too. I'm gonna put some more foam right there because that part is already dry. Like, just to show you guys, like I could wave that part too to make it all connect. I'm gonna leave this like how that is. And all, I mean, the best way I can tell you guys on how to do the finger waves is just to go in a C motion. It's a lot of back and forth. And that is that. That is that. So I'm going to put my wrap strips on. I think I'm only going to need two since I don't have to worry about nothing else in the back. It's a whole salon over here. So I have the black ones, the stretchy ones. And I definitely need one to make my sides smooth. And I'm tying below that wave. I don't want to smash it. And then put the second one. And I'm still not smashing this wave just right there. I guess I'm going to need to dry for maybe like 7 to 8 minutes. It's not going to take long. That's another reason why I want to take some of my hair off, because it's just too much. And then I'm going to spray this on it and go back under the dryer for like a minute after it's dry and spray this and go back underneath it for a little bit. And then if you want to, you can always add like some holding spray, but I like soft waves over like any type of crunch, because I can always comb it out and get like another hairstyle out of it. But this is optional if you do want to put something else in it. So I'll be back. Thank you. So guys, I'm just picking up my house right now. And then we're gonna go to Target after I finish doing this. So just wanna get you guys an update, and this is how my hair turned out. So just giving you guys a sneak peek of what I got going on for my outfit. So, and don't pay attention to my closet, it's a mess right now. But it's gonna be fire once y'all see the whole look. Okay guys, so I'm inside of Target and I'm looking at these sweaters on the folding on the table I'm gonna show you guys. And some plaid shirts. Let me see what I can see. I know that one is too dark for me, so I guess I won't be trying it after all. So yeah, I think that's it. Okay yo, so I'm back home from Target and I didn't get none of the clothes. I ain't had time. So it's basically 1 o'clock. So I'm about to put up the household stuff that I got from Target. And then throw out this trash. I need to still straighten my bathroom. And then I'm gonna go take a shower, and then we're going to start doing my makeup. And now that I've been out and about in the streets and I know the weather, I may need to replan my outfit. Child, it's just too much. And it's that time of the month for me too. So, I got a lot going on. But let me get started. morning, y'all. So we're in the car on our way to dinner.
Half a mile. Take the exit.
And I will put my outfit somewhere in here because somebody don't know how to take pictures of me. So I did the best that I could.
You go to school for photography.
Yeah. Unfortunately. But anyway, see you guys at the restaurant.
I just come through with a couple bossy bitches. They get money too. They some don't crossy bitches. Flossy bitches. Sergio Rossy bitches. And if we at the game, then it's flossy bitches.
Your destination is on the right.
Oh, man. Isn't this so sweet? Look at that.
Okay, you guys, so I'm closing out the vlog and I am taking off my makeup. So I'm using like a cold cream, the Pond's cold cream, and I'm gonna use a wipe to take everything off, and I'm gonna wash my face with this and do one of these and then put some moisturizer on my face and tie my hair down. And then we're going to find something to watch on TV. But I'm going to close the vlog here for you guys. And then I'll pick you guys up tomorrow for tomorrow's festivities. But the food that we had was really, really good. That fish. I need you guys another angle. Hold on. That. So the fish that I had was rockfish. It was a grilled rockfish. Of course it was whole, you guys seen that, and it was so good. That was a lot of fish. And then he had this rigatoni pasta with it was like ribeye cut in it, and it had king oyster mushrooms in a cream sauce, and I think it had peas and stuff in it. And then that cheesecake that I had was so fire. It was goat cheese cheesecake, which was so silky smooth, like it doesn't even, oh my god, I don't think I can eat regular cheesecake ever again. And I love cheesecake, like, but goat cheese cheesecake, it's like, I don't even know how to describe it. It's like, it's so smooth and creamy, and it tastes nothing like traditional cheesecake. So I don't know what I'm gonna do, because who else make goat cheese cheesecake? Please tell me. Or am I to learn how to make it myself? But and then the drink that I had was called Lady in Red, which was really good. I didn't get a chance to like B-roll the ambiance because it was a small space, but it was an intimate setting and they were like pretty packed in there. And it was like we had reservations, so as soon as they set us down, like our waiter had came to give us the specials, and you know, so it just was moving really fast. I didn't have time to B-roll it, but it was a nice ambiance. And what else did we? Oh, we had the fried green tomatoes with like the lump crab meat that was an appetizer. That was really, really good. That was my first time having fried green tomatoes. The only thing about the tomatoes that I would change is that whatever that they use for the breading, it was missing like some salt and pepper or like some type of season. But the crab meat itself was very flavorful, so it just needed a little salt and pepper on the tomatoes. But outside of that, it was good. And they make everything fresh in-house. And they get everything here locally. And they was like that they get like their cut of meat. Like they get like the whole cow. Like after they, you know, whoever kills the cow and, you know, take the hair off and take out the organs, they get the whole cow and then cut their own cuts of beef or whatever. So, but it was really good. I would go back there. It's just out of the area. It's probably like an hour away, but it was worth it. I liked it. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish cleansing my face, you guys, and see you guys. Okay, you guys, so today is Saturday, November the 6th. I'm going on part 2 of the birthday adventures. So, I will pick you guys up once we get to the location. We're going to go do a sip and paint. It's supposed to be a surprise, but I'm not good with surprises. I always try to figure out what it is. Let me know if it's a Scorpio thing.
Better than mine.
waiting for our paints to dry. I'm a little buzzed. I told y'all before my last vlog that I'm not a drinker, so this is my second drink. And we had some pretzel bites. I'm a little hungry, but I don't want to eat nothing else because I'm cooking dinner tonight for us. So, and going to the mall after this. So, want to see what they have in the mall. I'm going to run past H&M. Oh, that's the festival. Annapolis, and then it's Maggiano's. I haven't been to this mall in years, so I'm not gonna be in here long. I just wanna see what H&M has. I'm not even walking around too much because he's not coming in the mall. So we wanna see what we can find. Good. He's right here. You have to go far and look for it.
Looks like a pretty
decent size machine. This front has been popular on H&M. I'm not a big fan. Oh, this is the they have this shirt in my size because they have the pants, and I did like this set online. So they have these boots. I think they're cute. They feel, I mean, the quality feels like what the price is, but I think they are cute. They have them in like a suede. They also have like the buffet green bag and like a beanie. So they have some more of the Chelsea boots. Okay, yes, this is what I have on. I just have on my black jeans, my Chelsea boots, a blazer, and a graphic tee. I found some stuff, but the line is out the door, and the stuff that I found is not like
working with in this online. So, which I know this shirt is sold out online. And this blazer is really flimsy. It's like thinner than their normal blazers. So, I think I'm going to just bypass getting anything in store and see what I can find online. Money. Yeah. I'm just gonna go. Because this is a little gay section. Okay, see the line is all the way back here. And no, I'm not doing that. You guys, the line is out the door, and I found like some nice basics, but it wasn't worth me standing in a 30-minute line, because that line is definitely a 30-minute line. But don't want to go into Macy's. I don't even feel like looking for a MAC counter, because I do need like some little knickknack stuff, but I'm just not in the mood for long lines. I think I'm a little buzzed from the sipping paint. I can't do it. So let me call him and tell him to come to the front so we can go back home and I can make dinner. I'm gonna make steak and some roasted vegetables. And I don't know, maybe some mashed potatoes.